This is Oswego State Lakers, 24/7, Why Not Us. We rejoined the team on Monday, a short few days after the loss to the under-18 team. They go hard at practice. A big hit from defenseman Tim Carr hits the bench all the way up. The next day's practice is even harder. Their bodies are starting to take the toll. Game day has arrived. First, it's Coffee Club. Then, it's the Red Dragons.
I can't wait till Musi's metabolism shuts down. And he's overweight.
I think mine already did.
Musi, when you're about 200 pounds, I'm going to be getting all over you.
My Facebook picture would be a big fat slob.
He's going to look like White Goodman at the end.
Like bald,
I want that tournament. You can shoot a puck.
What is it?
Friends?
Jay,
get to work!
Yeah, Jay at work. Uh-huh.
Matt Singleton and Kyle Battle will get their first career start.
How do you feel about getting the start?
First start of the career, pretty pumped.
First start, how you feeling?
Good.
About an hour and a half till puck drop of the first conference game of the season. A good start will set the tone. It wouldn't be but 3 minutes until Corlin strikes first.
They score! Coletta, right in the goal mouth on his...
Less than 2 minutes later, Corlin strikes again. Oswego almost has its first goal of the game. But the refs think otherwise. After only 6 minutes in net and giving up two goals, veteran Andrew Hare gets pulled. It's Dan Jones' turn.
Trying to tee it up. In front, the Moody scores! Moody in the slot off the pass from Whitelaw, and the Lakers count 15.
Rodriguez carries it in left side. Circle, in front, score! Guess which line does it again? Rodriguez sets up Whitelaw, and the game is tied at two. Whitelaw at the left circle, looking up top. McConney, one-time shot, score!
3 unanswered goals puts the Lakers ahead going into the first intermission. But Coach Ed Gosick is not satisfied.
Settle down here a minute and just think. We talked about intensity on any given night. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter where you're at on here. In this league, you guys understand, you have got to bring it, and we didn't. And you started to do that, you changed the momentum of the game around. Maintain the discipline, maintain our focus. Guys are not ready to jump. I'm watching guys coming off the bench not moving their feet. So let's take a minute here and learn from that and that intensity level that's got to be there. Each and every shift. This was far from over, fellas. You just gave two opportunities late by not having good puck management in our own end. Simple plays in our own end. Everyone back, outnumber them, 5 guys low until we're sure we have possession. Then worry about breakout. We don't go to breakout until we get possession. Come on, fellas, let's build on that.
It wouldn't take long into the second period for Oswego to score its fourth goal of the game. Zach Josepher puts the tally on the board.
Zach Josepher jumps up in the rush and hammers it home, and the Lakers lead 4-2.
Just as fast as Oswego strikes, Cortland strikes as well with a goal of their own.
A great play down low by Moyer to get the deflection, and his second of the night has made it 4-3. But out to center, Kyle Badham finds room. Chris Ayotte will step into the zone. Ayotte in the high slot, score! Chris Ayotte restores the Lakers' two-goal lead. It's 5-3. Chris Brown with an empty net to center. Brown, long shot. He scores!
Chris Brown's empty net goal would seal the victory for Oswego, their first victory in conference play this season.
I don't even know where to start with those two. Whitey's just an all-around great hockey player, and so is Paul. But, they both bring something to the table. We all do. Whitey just is there in the back check, there in the forecheck. And Paul's just, especially when he lost all his weight, he's real fast out there. And, you can't say enough about those two, Whitey and P-Rod. They're awesome players. They're awesome people. And, I couldn't imagine playing with anybody the last 3 years.
Prove yourself tonight, 60 minutes. Let's finish this weekend off with two wins. All right, boys? Lakers on three. One, two, three.
Lakers!
Longtime Oswego State doctor William A. Mahon passed away in May. His time with the men's ice hockey team spanned over three decades. Loving husband, father, and dedicated doctor, Dr. Mahon will truly be missed. On just his second shift of the game, sophomore Peter Rodriguez seems to have hurt his wrist. There was no lack of scoring in this game. 9-0 the final, as Paul Rodriguez puts up 4 goals, Luke Moody 2 goals, Tyler Linebrock 2 goals. A much better comeback performance from last night.
Rebound scores! Rodriguez over the line. Moody streaks up the left side, walks right in the middle, and he scores! Here's Moody to the slot, he shoots, and off the post in behind Mill and in the net now. Rodriguez walks right in, shoots, scores!
Just on the weekend, fellas, we're hard on you like last night for a reason. And you know why. Because tonight is the type of performance that we're capable of. And last night, we all were to blame, coaches included, for not having the right mental preparation. So we have a good week of practice. We enjoy tonight. We stay out of trouble. Come back Monday. And we're ready to work and get prepared for first two road games of the year, two critical games for us as far as the league is concerned. Couldn't be proud of your effort tonight, and the family part of it for Doc, pretty awesome.
Obviously, I'd like to give to everybody, but...
Oh, shut up.
Oh, can't really do that.
Oh, goals.
Here, I shut up. Great goals. Great goals. Slimer, another couple. Every play pretty good, but not every day you get a shutout, so.
Next week's practice is lighter as they prepare for the first road trip of the season to Brockport and Geneseo.
He just sits and watches the people in the boxes. Everything he sees, he absorbs and adopts it. He mimics and he mocks it. Really hates the box, but he can't remember how to stop it. So he continues to watch it, hoping that it'll give him something that he can box with. with a how to locksmith. See the boxes locked in the box. Ain't got the combination to unlock. Yeah, this white box shit scares the look away. Cause at that moment, it might show him what to take off the locks with. So he chained himself to the box, took a lock, and then he locked it. Swallowed the combination and then forgot it. As the doctors jotted all down with their pens and pencils. The same ones that took away his voice and just left his instrumental like that.
As they settle in on the bus to Brockport, one thing goes through their minds. Victory.
You know, obviously there's some pretty joy in there, but at the same time I realize that's a great privilege and an honor. You know, we've had a lot of good captains here, and I just kind of want to follow in their footsteps. It's nice to be recognized by my peers and respected. It's just a responsibility that I've wanted, and you know, I was very happy to accept.
As they arrive in Brockport, the focus becomes clear. They have come to do a job. A job that requires hard work, muscle, grit, and determination.
Things here. I know we went over the scouting report in the locker room, but things that we think are important that we want to touch base on. Dano, you want to start us off here? Or?
Yeah, we can do a power play here first to get going, but just in general, let's lock in. The challenge is there for us to have a different Friday start than last Friday's. That's the challenge for us, and we know we have to do that. Lock in right now.
Again, attention to detail on our D zone. Taking pride in it. Remember what we talked about last week before the Elmira game, and I would just preach the same thing again. When we play strong defensively as a team and we stop in our areas and we're sharp and we're battling for loose pucks, we're very good in transition.
Yeah, I mean, coming here is kind of funny. I wasn't too sure who I was going to be placed with, and obviously looking at the class that I came in with, I knew there's a lot of skillful guys, and you know, Luke and Paul were both well known in our junior league back home, and so when I came here, I won't lie, it was almost a bit of an intimidation thing. I was, you know, a little worried to see, you know, how good they were going to be, and hoping that I might be able to keep up with them. Thankfully for the three of us, I think Eddie recognized right away that the three of us would work well together, as our games all kind of complement each other's.
Staying loose before the game is key for most players.
What do you attribute this leading award to? High break, keeping it simple.
Yeah,
too slow to get
into each other.
Workmanlike attitude tonight. We don't get too high, we don't get too low. We're all working for the common goal here. Walking around the hallways. And last Friday night, we were thinking this way. Right? Can't tell me we weren't, and that we were just going to come in and roll over. If you think for one second, you think about when we're playing St. Norbert or we're playing Amherst last year, the attitude of in your head. Guess what? That's how they think over them. That's how every one of these teams think. You've got to expect their best game tonight, their best effort. On and off the bench, working hard, little things, making plays. You don't think they're excited to play you? Are you ready to match that intensity? Because last Friday night we weren't. We've got confidence in you. You showed us that on Saturday night. That's the way we want to start off, with that same confidence, believing in one another. Prove how good we are here. We have to earn it every single night. Let's get it done here, boys.
Lakers on three. 1, 2, 3.
Lakers!
We'll be right back.
It's a long process here. Do not get frustrated. Now, hey, it wasn't a perfect period, but it wasn't an awful period. But a lot of guys just hoping it was going to come. Right? Let's have the right mental attitude here. Let's start playing like a veteran team here. Let's have confidence in one another.
Come on, boys. Come on, boys. Let's go.
The feeling that keep them coming back. Yeah, I create the feeling that keep them coming back. So captivating when I get it on the floor. Know y'all been patiently waiting. I know you need me. I can feel it. I'm a beast. I'm an animal. I'm that monster in the mirror. The headliner.
As the second period starts, things are slow until Zach Josepher throws one at the net.
Josepher scores! There you go, Connor, just put it on net. And Zach Josepher finally breaks through, and the Lakers have a 1-0 lead.
So, boys, that's a better effort there. That's a better effort. Each guy holding themselves responsible here. Some good efforts there out of a lot of guys, a lot of good teamwork. Our execution partner, decision making, maybe was still a hair off there, but it was clearly better. So we build on that. We have our best period here in the third. Everybody pulling together. Hey, it's a battle right to the end here, fellas. And we have to be prepared for that. Use our experience in these situations to make good plays, to outwork them. These are games that are gonna make us better. We use our experience, we use our composure to play smart. But that means aggressive. We're not sitting back here trying to protect some lead. We're going at it by making smart plays. Continue to get pucks to the net. Continue to keep digging until you hear the whistle. But when you do, back off so that he doesn't call that. All right, any questions here? Come on, boys, here we go.
As they start the third period, Andrew Hare looks for his second shutout in a row. In the middle of the period, Luke Moody scores the dagger.
The Lakers taking advantage of a turnover, and Rodriguez finds Moody 2-0.
Dubs all around!
Very good job. Staying focused, staying patient on the bench, right? Just getting the greasy golden. So, very good job staying focused on the bench, every one of you. Okay, nice job.
Those are the games where, hey, it can go south in a hurry. And you hung tough. You didn't make excuses. It was a good effort as a team. And that's where your experience comes through. And that's why you stay the course. You stay positive.
Anyways, good win. That was a good first road win for us. I thought a lot of guys battled tonight. Battling, sacrificing the body. Moody's line, you guys had a really good night. But I'm going to give it to the guy with the G-dub.
I just want to say, you know, obviously we wanted to come in here and destroy them, but, you know, we still got the win, and that was a dogfight to the end. I'm proud of all you guys. So.
Happy birthday!
The next night, Geneseo is the target. Just as ferocious and hungry, the Lakers come. On the road, the luxury of the campus center goes away. They are their own equipment managers. Coach Digby and the defense have a meeting before warm-ups.
Okay, just real quick, okay, behind here, but a couple things to touch on after the video this morning. One, we can be a hell of a lot better than we were last night. Biggest reason for the problems, we weren't moving our feet, right? We weren't anticipating enough, getting our feet going enough, right, to make the right play. Tonight, let's do that. Let's get our feet going, let's move, not only with the puck.
Some guys like being in their own head. Ritual as usual for Bobby Gritsakis as he stick handles with a golf ball.
Doesn't matter who we're playing, our main focus is always on us and how we execute, how we play. I already talked about the discipline factor. Discipline from all means. The shift time, to not saying anything to the refs, to keeping our focus. Talked with some guys today out on the ice of practice about not showing negative emotion. And hey, it's a process from now. It doesn't mean it's all going to just, you're just going to turn the switch and stop being who you've been for all your years of minor hockey. Things don't go well, hey, we react positively. Keep your mouth shut. We never show any frustration level. Okay? It brings our team down, shows the other teams getting under our skin. Second night of two on the road. A smart, intelligent road game tonight. We take what they get us, we keep our shift short, we keep our focus every single face off, and we get pucks in the net every opportunity we can.
The final score was 10-1 Oswego. Almost every single player registered a point, and 10 different players scored goals. Monday is goalie practice. Coached by silver medalist of the 1972 Olympic ice hockey team, Pete Sears.
Then he's going to go to the other corner, pass out the slot. Bing, bing.
Take a look at the stars, can reach if you want to. Don't be afraid to change, because the people don't want to. Be who you want to, dream if you want to. Always be yourself and the people will want you. No, we don't care what the people say. You know we're going to do it big anyway. You know we're going to do it big anyway. You know.
It's their home opener tomorrow night. They've been on the road for their first four or five games. They played, they had one goal game above state. Overtime loss to Fredonia. They're playing better than they did at the beginning of the year. And for us, it's all going to be mental. Are we going to go in there willing to compete and battle and earn it?
Thursday night's practice is a little bit rougher than expected as the D-men perform with pads.
Angel on the mic, give me a beat, I'll show you magic. We born in different planes, but we also far from average. Look, I'm passing, cause the lane you in is way too full of traffic. See, I'm living like a dream, though it's rare to see me sleeping. From Dallas out to...
The boys have arrived in Morrisville. The usual preparation for the game begins with light banter from Chris Brown and R.J. Barra.
All right, this makes perfect. You know what my Carson Jr. used to say? Perfect practice makes perfect.
You know what mine used to say?
Big difference.
You suck, okay? Mine used to always say, get better in your own zone.
Thoughts on who won in the KHL opener?
Don't really care. Bad league.
Thoughts on the first Geno?
Oh, it was good to get out of the way. Good pass by Chris Muse. Nice little 2-on-1. A little bit lucky to get it in there, but it's good.
Wasn't lucky.
Well, it's not at all. It's all good. It's good to get it out of the way.
Stop goal scorer's mind. Goal.
Mucker's goal.
How would you say they're constructing that?
I think it's an M. Lies.
Transformers. Is that the finished product right there?
Yeah, you'll see it better down there. There's just the ground.
Healy and the gang are here. Taking in the slowly. Or just the wave?
He's going, bro. He's going.
Hey, yo, Healy, give me a hard time about missing bats, eh? Missing open bats.
Healy's going pro before any of us do. That's for sure.
Did you hear the call on my goal?
Titanic has been struggling with open nets, but he finds this one, or something like that.
Break would be nice, so points with boys are sick.
Yeah, we need them.
Even getting away from the rink for a couple of days, it's just such a good feeling. When you get back, you're just like, you know, revived.
Yeah.
You like hockey again.
Yeah.
What do you think of their puck setup there, Ben?
Well, I like ours. It's a nice M. Theirs kind of fell apart, which is hopefully a
sign.
Foreshadowing.
Yes. English skills.
Business.
I'm going for the gold, my heart is in control, my mind is on succeed, and I am in the lead. Don't buy into the schemes, the science on strategy, just giant in UT's, brings triumph and belief. I'm relying on redeem, inspired by the green, never tired, no fatigue, never defiant to my team, never lying on a thing until I'm lying on a thing, hooked to wires and things, I'ma die as a king if I don't do it now.
We've broken the season up, fellas, we have told you in 5 game segments. And right here, season will be a fifth of the way done, 20% after tonight. Okay, you're 4-0 going into this one here on the road. Okay, let's take care of this first segment here, each shift, each period, and get out of here and get the job done in a positive way.
Besides, we're the same. Who's guiding the train? Who's flying the plane? Who's driving the lane? Who dies when it bang? Who fires when it bang? Who lies in the aim? 2 lives in a drain. Who cries when they sing? You hide, but you came. You hide, but
wait,
you
came. Wait, now shoot. McDonald to save with the blocker. The rebound slapped in front. Scores! Matt Singleton on the doorstep. Hammers it home on the power play. The Lakers lead 1-0. Moving, bringing it around the outside. And he's going to come back into the zone. Jarvis tries to join the rush. Marcus pulls up, drops it to Jarvis, a backhand score!
I am a wink, I'm a retire in a bank, yeah. And I'm no quitter, cause I'm a go-getter. I'm no quitter.
Speeds up the right side, trying to get around one. AF to the quick shot, he scores! What a rush by Chris Aon into the offensive zone, and he goes top shelf to give the Lakers a 2-1 lead.
John Whitelaw, senior captain, has seemed to hurt his ankle. It doesn't look very good.
Here to be the enemy's misery. No stress visibly, neither does it enter me. I think positively. You can't harm me mentally, not physically, not spiritually. You never get rid of me. I am the epitome.
Breakaway at the end of the first. Chris Sackett plays it across. One timer, Jones,
and I take whatever I'm visioning. I break all of the limiting. I shake all of the gimmicking. The fakery, the trickery.
Clear across the wide open net.
Let's pull it together here for 20, fellas. Come on. This thing's far from over. Let's have the right mindset here. We need to win this period. That's it. Forget the scoreboard here. It's 0-0. We're in a hostile environment on the road. Our captain's down and out here. Let's help him pull together here, boys.
And I'm no quitter.
Still no shot. Finally, Brown lets the one-timer go, and he scores! Chris Brown, a rocket from the left circle. The Lakers' fourth power play goal of the night, and they lead 5-1.
Yeah, I'm allergic to cheating. I hate failure, and I am in love with achievement. Above and beneath it, a hug when I greet it. My eyes on...
Captain John Whitelaw watches practice from the sidelines, nursing his ankle injury.
Are you back for spring training or what? We need you.
Game day once again at the Campus Center Ice Arena. This time, Buffalo State has come to town.
Hey, Friday night games, okay, we got to change this. We've struggled here. We got to get going right off the get-go here. Every single guy in this room pulling it up here and getting a better result here of the way we play on Fridays. Let's get it going.
Benches Clint. He'll take it back to Kramer with a one-time shot. Blocked down in front. Scores! Matt Bessing on the rebound in the slot. And I don't think Hare saw the puck as it sat there. A power play goal puts the Bengals ahead 1-0. Bessing feeds it right to the front. Scores! He hooks up with Brett Hope on the doorstep. And the Bengals again convert on the power play, this time the two-man advantage, and have a 2-0 lead. Brown brings it in, Titanic to the front. Brown pulling up, shooting, off Titanic, and in the net! The Lakers score and are on the board. David Titanic had to go off his body and into the net, and it is 2-1.
Most of those calls we deserve. Most of them we deserve. Can't ram guys from behind. Again, not moving our feet, using our sticks. So let's use our heads here and learn from it. We got a huge kill here to start off this second period. We talk about gaining momentum all the time, staying more disciplined. Forget the refs. Forget it. It'll even up here. At some point, it'll even up. And so we got to keep our mouth shut. Let's not get into this stuff where we're worrying about them. Coaches included. Forget it. I'm not talking anymore. It doesn't matter how obvious or bad or whatever it is. That's it. So all of us, we on board here?
Yeah.
Fellas, again, just on the discipline part here, huge, huge kill here to start. Let's play 5-on-5 hockey here. Let's get things turned around here. Let's play with confidence. We're the home team here. We're better than we just showed. Let's get it done.
Come on, boy, let's go.
So much for the fast start the Lakers wanted, as the Bengals score only 10 seconds into the period.
He was able to just walk up the right wing and rip it top shelf on Hare, and the Bengals restore their two-goal lead. It's 3-1. Brown into Moody to the front of the net. Scores! Zach Josepher on the back door with a goal in four consecutive games, and the Lakers back within one. He's got a screen. Got it across. A on one-timer. Scores! Another bomb from Chris Ayotte, and on the power play, the Lakers have tied it at 3.
Good energy coming back, fellas. Again, 5-on-5. Using our heads, being disciplined, drawing the penalties, taking advantage of it. 20 miles, fellas. The discipline factor, better that period. Let's keep it going this period. That's a positive. Pucks to the net, solid D zone here. This game is ours here, fellas. This game is ours.
Rodriguez gets free in the right circle and scores! Paul Rodriguez into the 100-point club, and the Lakers, for the first time tonight, take the lead. It's 4-3. He steps into the zone. Rodriguez to Moody, scores! Well, it's sure nice having John Whitelaw, but Rodriguez and Moody are quite the duo themselves. And they now make it 5-3 with Moody's goal.
Us or break us. Those games like that. We don't take it the wrong way. The 9-0, the 10-0, they're fun. You guys have fun. The games that are going to make us a better team are games like this. We'll have lots of video. Don't take it the wrong way. Just, we've got to be better than that. Positive is, hey, things could have went south very easily. 3 5-on-3s in the first period. Much better. Again, did I like that part of it? No. But in the second and the third, much smarter there. But little things, again, you can't let teams like that hang around. We got the opportunity when it's 5-on-3 to put the dagger in, right? Instead, they're pulling the goalie there. And so my point on that is you can't lose that amount of intensity. You cannot lose the focus. When it's there, you can't be thinking that way. Many times you've all been on teams where you've seen it come back to haunt you, to have that killer instinct. Proud of your effort tonight. Discipline in the second and third. Guys pulling together. Okay, little stuff on the bench there. We'll address that tomorrow. But all in all, hey, a lot of adversity tonight. Caused by the refs, things not going our way, guys getting frustrated, and you found a way to get it done. So great effort tonight. Let's get some rest. 11 o'clock tomorrow.
Just Paulie, congratulations.
Obviously, P-Rod.
Can you repeat that?
Oh, yeah. Sweet.
If Luke can't talk that well, this might not be
the best thing I've ever
seen. Boys, it means a lot, but we battled through there in the third period. You know, we're down in the first, but like props to everyone. You know, it's a great battle, and let's come back stronger tomorrow.
Let me send me a voice note for fun.
About the house went blue.
I come home one Friday, had to tell the landlady I done lost my job. She said that don't confront me, long as I get my money next Friday. Now next Friday I come, I didn't get the rent, and out the door I went. So I goes to the landlady.
The Fredonia Blue Devils are in town tonight as the team looks to bounce back from a sloppy game yesterday against the Buffalo State Bengals. Taylor Ferris stays loose on game day by moving with the music.
Sally against the glass.
First G of the year.
How's she going?
I'm gonna celebrate.
It might be tonight. It might be tonight.
It will be tonight.
It might be tonight. It might be tonight.
It will be tonight.
It might be
tight.
How about Brownie's Beauty showing up tonight? How fired up are you?
What are your thoughts, Christopher?
Giving a shout out to the boys in Section 51 tonight.
There's a release and there's another one.
Unleash the Bad Ham.
Okay. Oh, I loved it in Morrisville last week. It was Mrs.
Bad Ham. Good jerk.
That'd be copious amounts of gong tonight in the Campus Center.
Can you give me a definition of gong?
What's the definition of gong? How can we explain?
Gong is tough to explain. Some people have gong, some people don't have gong. Some people create gong, some people just can't create gong.
Brownie, for instance,
some people gong. Gong.
My buddies tonight, get them on film, gong.
Your hair looks better than average today.
Wonder what I did?
Fonzo.
Took a shower and put a hat on. It's the only way it stays flat.
Fonzo.
Call me Fez.
Tonight will be the second game in a row without Captain John Whitelaw. Let's see how the Lakers fare.
Good career numbers against Fredonia, and he has it again down low. Tries to stuff his way to the front. He scores! Well, right on cue. Good career numbers against Fredonia, and that continues. 1-0 Lakers. Up to Rodriguez. Makani, a one-timer. He misses wide. Rebound, Moody scores! Luke Moody firing the rebound from the goal line. It goes off the pad of Friesen in behind him. The Lakers with a good start on the power play, 2-for-2, and a 2-0 lead. Rodriguez to the check, Muse moving in with Moody, Muse to Moody, and he couldn't get a shot away, and it's in the net! Paul Rodriguez following up after Friesen took a tumble, and Friesen may be injured. It is 3-0 Oswego. He wins it, but it's poked free, and trying to step back, Ayotte 2-on-1 with Banham. Singleton moves up to a 3-on-1. Ayotte scores! Chris Ayotte leads the 2-on-1, rips the wrister by Holloway. The Lakers restore their 3-goal lead. It's 4-1. Moody down low. Brown lets it go. Rodriguez right to the front. Scores! Rodriguez to Moody. I've heard that before. It's 5-1 Lakers. Rodriguez back to Makani again. Middle point. Ayotte fakes it off his skate. Has to pivot in the circle. Ayotte turning around, moving to the middle. Shooting. Scores! Everything finding Twine off the stick of number 12. The Lakers special teams are perfect tonight, and they have a 6-1 lead.
A total of 7 goals. Luke Moody with a hat trick and 2 assists. Paul Rodriguez had 6 points, 5 assists, plus a goal. Chris Muse scored his first goal of the season. And Chris Ayotte with 2 goals of his own.
As far as the weekend, hey, Much better effort tonight. Much better execution. Good, solid team effort this weekend. Great job getting it done. We'll practice Monday, Tuesday. You get a nice break next week. And we come back for those four games focused and prepared. Tough time of year. Your academics, the papers, the tests, and so forth. So it's an opportunity this next week. Yeah, rest, relax, have some fun, but take care of your work so that you come back. You're not worrying about the academic part. You got that stuff taken care of. And then we're ready and we're focused for Platy and Potsdam. And then our two non-league games. So there's a long way to go here, fellas. Great start so far.
Just want to say congratulations, Moody, 50th ball. It's a big accomplishment. But just want to give us the music, you know, monkeys off his back.
Yeah.
I want to tell you a story about the house went blue. I come home one Friday, had to tell the landlady I done lost my job. She said, that don't confront me, long as I get my money next Friday. Now next Friday I come, I didn't get the rent, and out the door I went. So I goes to the landlady, I said, you let me slide. I have the rent for it tomorrow, the next day I don't know. So say, let me slide it on, you know, people.
Join us next episode as we dive into Whiteout Weekend. Plus, can the number one Oswego State Lakers stay unbeaten? This is Oswego State Lakers 24/7. Why not us?